And we really want to hear from the chair of the National Construction Authority, Michelle.
The situation at Huruma seems to have gotten a lot worse. Residents are being evacuated from their buildings. In fact, Nairobi Deputy Governor Jonathan Mweke will be holding a press briefing in a few minutes to inform Kenyans that residents of this area of Huruma should, in fact, evacuate their buildings. All the buildings surrounding this area have been deemed unsafe for human settlement. But speaking to us now is the chair of the National Construction Authority, Mr. Steve Oundo. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Now, this situation seems to be escalating, but let's begin with the building that collapsed. Did this building have clearance from the National Construction Authority?
Yes, first and foremost, National Construction Authority is involved in the process during construction. We don't have the information that we have right now is that this building was done about 5 years ago. We'll confirm that. We were not in existence then. But what I just wanted to bring to the attention of the public is that when you are doing construction, one of the certificates you require is a certificate of compliance from the National Construction Authority. And when we are given that certificate, what do we check for? We check for, one, does the building have approval from the county government? Number two, we check, does the contractor on site, is he registered by the National Construction Authority? Number three, is the project itself registered with the National Construction Authority? Number four, has the project paid the necessary levy during that particular registration process? We also want to certify if there is an architect, a quantity surveyor, and a structural engineer, services engineer on site. We also look at the safety standards. So if you notice right now, our act is quite limiting because it's just during the process of the building. Now, when a building is complete, the next step is you're supposed to get an occupation certificate. Now, the occupation certificate currently is issued by the county government, okay? And the occupation certificate is supposed to certify that a building is safe for human habitation, and at the same time, the functions for which it has been designed meet the standards.
Did this building have those particular documents?
I am almost sure this building did not have the occupation certificate. Remember, that is what, and I've been saying this time and again, wherever you are, can you please ask your landlord, if you're a tenant or if you're the owner of a building, can you ensure that you do get the occupation certificate? Your building will not be insured if you do not have an occupation certificate, because that is what shows that the required standards have been met.
Now, just before you continue, you said that the mandate of the National Construction Authority is only limited to the period of building, but are you aware or are you informed when buildings are being put up? Because many of these buildings now surrounding this collapsed building are being deemed as unfit for human settlement. Were you aware of that?
Let me put it this way. As I was saying, if you're building and you don't apply to the National Construction Authority for a compliance certificate, we're not likely to know about it. But we also do have our inspectors who go around checking on compliance sites. One of the things we've also said, any site that does not have a site signboard is definitely a recipe for disaster during construction. Okay, and then let's also move forward so that we can see how to address this particular problem, because we do have quite a number of buildings here. We have the Building Inspectorate Unit at the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development that has actually done an exercise in this area. I think they audited about 2,000 buildings. And the findings of that audit were three things. There are certain buildings where they ordered the immediate evacuation of the tenants because it was quite clear that the structural stability of those buildings was in question. There are other buildings where they ordered the owners or the developers to engage consultants to bring in reinforcement so that the building is strong. Then there are also those which it didn't matter. I mean, if a building is on a road reserve, such a building from the audit, the only way forward is demolition. And I would like to just call upon, it's very sad in a scenario like this where you have innocent Kenyans who've lost their lives, you have people who have been injured, some have been maimed, that is also property that is lost. It is not the kind of thing you want for a development country like ours. But going forward, I see the solution to this predicament being the better coordination of all the agencies that are involved in construction. It's a bit sad if I can only come here and I only have control of the contractor. The other challenge we've been having, even on the sites that are ongoing, that we normally do inspection of, is when we bring a stop to the works, especially when it's to do with safety conditions, especially when it's to do with lack of approval, our act is limiting in the sense that we do not have prosecution powers so that we can actually charge those. But I think with the good intervention of the highest office of this country and also with Parliament, if that can also be added to our mandate so that we do have the prosecutional powers. Any building that is already up, our act does not cover that. We are not able to do that, but we'd really love, and that is what we've proposed as an amendment to the National Construction Authority Act, so that we're not just limited to the period of construction, but we are also able to deal with buildings after construction or those buildings that were even done well before the inception of the authority.
Okay. And speaking of inter-agency cooperation, the county government says that they have carried out several audits of buildings that have flouted construction rules. You yourself say the NCA has carried out several audits and marked buildings that have flouted construction rules. But how is it that both of these two bodies seemed to miss almost all of the buildings in Huruma area?
In this particular area, from at least the report that has been done by the building inspectorate unit, I believe that this particular area has been covered. Now the thing is, what we need is capacity in relation to, if a building has been condemned and it should be demolished, you know, the first onus is of course on the owner to be given instructions to have it demolished. But if that's not the case, the next onus is of course on the authority to use their resources to demolish, and then they can follow up the recovery of those finances from the developer. But right now, as an authority, National Construction Authority, we don't have that power yet to be able to demolish. And that is what we are asking a revision to the law, so that we can be given those teeth to bite at that sector.